A smiling and visibly happy Patty Blagojevich apologizing to all of the reporters and cameramen here for starting this press conference late. She joked around that she couldn't find her husband's socks. That getting a laugh out of the crowd here. Dozens and dozens of supporters are here to witness this moment, but there is no disguising the toll that Blagojevich's imprisonment has taken on his family.
It's been a long time since I've shaved with a normal razor, and it takes a little practice. I'm sorry about that. I got to keep dabbing the blood.
So I have to apologize for his tardiness. He couldn't find where I put his socks this morning.
Lots changed in the nearly 8 years that I've been here. Let me just say a couple of things. First of all, the obvious I want to state, and that I know I speak for Patty and Amy and Annie, and obviously for me, we want to express our most profound and everlasting gratitude to President Trump. How do you properly thank someone who's given you back the freedom that was stolen from you? He didn't have to do this. He's a Republican president. I was a Democratic governor. And doing this does nothing to help his politics. President Trump is a man who is tough and outspoken, but he also has a kind heart. And this is an act of kindness, and I also believe it's the beginning of the process to actually turn an injustice into a justice. Sorry about this blood. All these years away, I never stopped reminding myself of the words from a poem. It's called The Gate of the Year. Go out into the darkness and put your hand into the hand of God. That shall be to you better than light and safer than a known way. It's been a long time since I've been home, nearly 8 years, nearly 3,000 days. I suppose a better way to measure how long it's been is through our daughters, Amy and Annie. When I left home so long ago, Amy, our older daughter, was a sophomore in high school. And it'll be 2 years this spring since she's graduated from college, and now just recently, Amy earned a master's degree. And we're very proud of you, sweetheart. And Annie, our younger daughter, was 8 years old when I left. She was about this high. Now she's 16, and now she has her driver's license. And she's doing good in school, and she plays the piano, and we're very proud of her, too. Look at you, sweetheart.
An extraordinary scene here in Ravenswood Manor. Scores of national and local media here, along with dozens of supporters and the curious. This was the scene last night, just about midnight. Rod Blagojevich returning home for the first time in 8 years. It took the former governor some time to reach his front door with all of the people and all the press. It was back in 2011 when the disgraced former governor was sent to a federal penitentiary outside Denver, a jury convicting Blagojevich on 18 corruption counts from attempting to shake down hospital and racetrack CEOs for campaign contributions, and of course famously trying to sell Barack Obama's vacant Senate seat in 2008, Blagojevich taking the time to thank President Donald Trump for commuting his 14-year sentence.
We want to express our most profound and everlasting gratitude to President Trump. How do you properly thank someone who's given you back the freedom that was stolen from you? He didn't have to do this. He's a Republican president. I was a Democratic governor. And doing this does nothing to help his politics. President Trump is a man who is tough and outspoken, but he also has a kind heart. And this is an act of kindness, and I also believe it's the beginning of the process to actually turn an injustice into a justice.
President Trump finally pulling the trigger after months of contemplating the possibility of a pardon or commutation torture for Patty Blagojevich and her two daughters. Blagojevich pleading over the airwaves for Trump to free her husband, but it has finally happened. Blagojevich discharged from the penitentiary. Reporters, including our own Julie Unruh, encountering Blagojevich at the Denver airport last night before he flew to Chicago. Now, in a rambling press conference that just ended a short while ago, Blagojevich talking at length about wrongful convictions in the United States and also about his own conviction. So Rod Blagojevich, as loquacious as ever, with 8 years of pent-up energy, talking to reporters, talking to the public about his conviction and his return home. In the Ravenswood Manor neighborhood, Julian Cruz, WGN News.
All right,